there is a question here. Why all these reductions are happening? What is going on here? Let's take this 12-story building. Maybe it's not for this one, but it's an example. And think that for concrete wall building structures, we expect a large participation from the first mode, right? And smaller participation from the higher modes. And these are the dynamic characteristics of the building. Now we have to consider also the input, which is the ground motion. And we can have ground motions that around the periods of the first mode response have similar spectral acceleration. We scale the ground motions that way. But we might have a big difference in spectral acceleration around second and higher modes. And also by observing the second mode shape, we can see that at 6 and 12 floor, we should expect larger contribution of these higher modes. But at 10th floor, where it's close to the the second mode node, we expect not that much response. Let's see some results. Let's use a ground motion that produce large spectral acceleration around higher modes. And focus on the 6th and 12th floor. We can see in terms of connection forces, the large forces that are observed for the case of rigid elastic connections are significantly reduced by using these deformable connections in both floors. However, if we go to the 10th floor, the demand is not significant even when we are using the rigid elastic connections. So by using the deformable connection, there is not much to reduce there. Now, in case of the ground motion that doesn't have significant large spectral acceleration around second and higher modes, we see that the rigid elastic case, the building with rigid elastic connection, doesn't have much response, so, and it's similar to the case of deformable connections. Going to terms of base shear, similar observations. When we have a ground motion with high spectral acceleration, we have significant base shear, but we are able to reduce it by using deformable connections. However, in the case of this ground motion, we didn't have anything to reduce, even with the rigid elastic connections. Last, same observations also in terms of floor total acceleration. And I show this just for completeness. So with this, we understand that these deformable connections allow us to reduce the force and acceleration responses that are mainly from higher mode responses. So that's an indicator of when it's good to use this kind of system.